Police have revealed more than 50 people were caught carrying knives in the days before three stabbing attacks rocked Sydney. The force now pushing the government to toughen up knife laws, and even parents are in their sights.
Pouring out of a bus and into a panic, school children scattered to safety, this teen seen holding what appears to be a knife. This was a week ago in Doonside. Two brothers were stabbed, an 18-year-old killed. The start of one of, if not the worst weeks of knife crime we've seen. Police have had enough.
Every day police are seizing knives from individuals.
Each year officers undertake Operation Foil, random searches of people for weapons.
Last week we ran Operation Foil, which seized 51 knives.
Prompting police to push for tougher penalties, even for parents.
Everyone has a role, and parents have a role if they can influence their children, of course.
If parents knowingly let their children out the door with a dangerous weapon like a knife, then yes, they should have the book thrown at them.
Police are also pushing the government to make carrying a knife in or around public transport a separate high-risk offence that could lead to a custodial sentence. They believe that will be a greater deterrence than just fines.
The government doubled penalties for knife offences last year, the maximum for possession now 4 years and a $4,400 fine. Most offenders since then have escaped jail. Five teens have been charged over the Doonside murder. Bill Hogan, 7 News.